Alright, we're doing the Kuranda Scenic Railway today. It's day 22 or 21, I think. But first, a little breakfast, of course. Whoa. Quick pit stop at the Barron. On the plan today, this is a map of Kuranda. We're going to do a jungle walk, maybe the riverboat tour. Look at this, guys. We're feeding
turtles,
the fish and turtles.
Two types. Woo! Although most of the turtles around us right now, they're saw shell. Never eat.
Freshwater
crocodile. For a crocodile to eat, they have to blend in. Other animals create paths that come down to the water.
World Heritage Rainforest.
Tropics rainforest, very fast growing, very fast self-seeding rainforest. If you leave your house on holidays for a month, you'll come back. The rainforest has moved in. She's our most tolerant crocodile.
Boat tour done was amazing. First freshwater crocodiles in the wild. We saw three of them. And now, jungle walk. And maybe we might see a cassowary in the wild. Who knows? That's my dream. That's my platypus. The beautiful creek. Wow. Last stop. The largest butterfly garden of Australia. Signs. Back to Cairns. Oh, hey guys! So tonight we slept again in the car. It was very cozy. But today we're going to the Great Barrier Reef to three diving or snorkeling locations, which will be awesome. And by the way, we're in Port Douglas at the moment.
Stars. flashing signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. Kills me, makes me feel alive. Lately, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars.
Barrier Reef was awesome, just having some dinner, but we are back in Cairns actually because we met some people and we're going out tonight for a final time in Australia. On our way to Fitzroy Island. Fitzroy Island. Searching our friends from yesterday, also the reason why we are here. Okay, we're on Fitzroy Island, day 24, by the way. We did some snorkeling, it was very nice with a lot of turtles. I didn't have my GoPro, so that's a pity. I also saw another white-tip reef shark, like 10 meters from the beach. Yeah, quite extraordinary, I guess. And now we're walking to the number one beach in Australia, according to I don't know who, like the ranking system. So it should be very beautiful.
And here it is. Already a sneak peek. It's a very small beach.
Going for probably for the final snorkel of this holiday, right there in the sea. And I don't have any snorkel myself. Snorkeling gear, but there's nobody here, so I guess I'll take it.
Thief.
And put it back. Okay guys, snorkeling at the beautiful beach was awesome, but here's another new bird we're seeing for the first time. Yep, there weren't any turtles or sharks, but I saw a lot of beautiful fish, basically the same ones as in the Barrier Reef, the parrot fish and all that stuff. Well, this looks pretty. Doesn't it? Alright, we drove up north to the Daintree rainforest. Here is the Daintree River, and the only way to the national park is with a ferry across this river. It's quite late, it's 11 p.m. 11:15. So we're just in time because it closes at midnight basically. But the ferry is on its way. And we're going to sleep in the backpackers in the Daintree forest. We're in Daintree Crocodile Village. Very nice room actually. And it's literally in the middle of Daintree. It's like, yeah, little pots going all over the place. We're at the Daintree Discovery Center. And we might see cassowary here. Yeah. The Daintree rainforest, 130 million years old, making it the oldest one on Earth. Alright guys, right in the middle of the Daintree rainforest, oldest forest in the world, world heritage. This is a crocodile territory, estuarine crocodiles, the largest, most dangerous ones. Yeah, if you see any, you'll definitely see it. But we are going to take a little walk, with caution. Look at this crocodile territory. And another beach on our way to Cape Tribulation. Let's check it out. So beautiful here. Isn't it, Gasper?
Yes, it is.
There are some mudskippers there. Very small.
Alright, Casper is still setting up his tent, but this will be our place for the coming 3 nights. The beach is right there, very close. Yeah, there's like a camp kitchen, toilet facilities, our car. There's our campsite. Let's make our way to the beach. Our home for the next 3 days. No, oh, they actually look like baby huntsmen, so pretty safe, but I'm no expert in touching them, of course. Yeah, there's another one. Yep. I bet you there's a crocodile in here. It's like perfect estuarine scenario connected with the ocean. There's a lot of movement of fish, so there's food, but it's like the end of the day. It's coming, we're going to the camping, eat something, hang out around the campfire, and we'll probably see you guys tomorrow. Day 26, guys. Oh, look at this little buck. We're at Mason swimming hole, still pretty early, about 9 a.m. Look at all those fish. Basically the only place we can swim in Cape Tribulation, because there are no crocs here. Normally it's very busy here, but because we're so early, there's nobody. Pretty cold still, not very sunny yet, but it's actually getting clear, as you can see. Yeah! But I'm going for a swim. Wim Hof method style, let's go. Don't film me. I'm sorry.
Oh, why? Why am I doing this? Oh. Is that a croc? I think it's like -7. But there's something going on with physics and ice.
What do you mean?
Stonefish? Yeah, it should be ice, but it isn't. Now it's okay.
Okay, I'm just drying up in the sun and I found a little mimosa plant. Look at this. How awesome is that? Boop! 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 First crocodile burger ever. Crocodile hunt.
What? A male.
The one you saw in the water is over 40, 44.
Look at that.
Is he step on that?
So beautiful.
All right, dream come true. I just saw a cassowary. It literally was right here along the car, but we saw it right over there. Yeah, we just went for a little hike to see one, actually, a hike we had already done. We came back to the parking. There was a lot of people watching, and there was a cassowary. You saw the footage, so yeah. Now I can peacefully die.
We're in the Daintree rainforest. Presumably no crocodiles here. Let's hope that's true.
Day 27, our final complete day in Australia. I'm going to do this trail again, but completely. It's about 4 hours. It's now 9 a.m. or something, a little earlier. Then we're going to eat some emu and kangaroo. And we have a night walk guide at 7:30 p.m. for 2 hours. That's what we have planned today. And like, well, making our luggage a little bit, cleaning the car maybe. So yeah, the first walk, maybe another cassowary, who knows?
Not the easiest path. It's been like this for over an hour now.
3 more hours to go, let's go.
There is a house in New Orleans. They call the rising sun.
This little bloodsucker was on Casper's leg. Okay, after 2 hours we made it. Top of Mount Sorrow, apparently. We're inside a cloud at the moment. Yeah, it's about 2 hours back.
Little teenager.
Look at that, guys. So there are actually the males that care for them, that care for the young. There are soul dads. There are about 4,000 left in the wild. And as you can see, it's eating the blue cassowary fruit. It's toxic to humans, but about 98% of the seeds that go through the stomach germinate. While only 4% germinate if it doesn't go through a cassowary tract. 99% of its diet is fruit. And the other 1% is just insects and small rodents. Alright guys, it's still day 27, but we already packed our tents and luggage. It was such a mess in the car. Tonight we're going to do a night walk to spot our final creatures, I guess. And we're going to sleep in our car tonight, just here on our spot, because we'll have to leave early and it might rain, so now our tents are packed dry.
Matchbox thing.
They wouldn't be sleeping like this together normally. All see them?
Yep.
This is how they avoid getting eaten at night by the snakes.
A huntsman. The rainforest. We're lucky we packed our tents.
Day 28, our final day. Just doing a morning walk. It's 7:27 a.m. Final day, Cape Tribulation. We're going to take the car back to Cairns. It's a 2.5 hour drive. Hopefully everything will go perfect, because we still have to take the ferry over the Daintree River. The plane is at 6 p.m., so we still have some time left in Cairns and here probably.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains.
Before,
a river.
After,
life is old there.
dinner with a view.
Crocodile satays as an entree,
and as our main, octopus and kangaroo steak.
There's some exciting new science stuff coming, some more advanced biotech tribe. If you want to see that, it's going to be very exciting. Thanks for watching, see you next time.